Containerized weapon systems are way more terrifying than you probably think. We're talking about cruise missiles, drone swarms, anti-air systems, and even massive 1,000-foot defense barriers, all deployed right out of a simple shipping container. Opening or scanning these containers with an X-ray machine would, of course, solve this problem. The issue is that over 20 million shipping containers are moving globally at any given time, on cargo ships, train cars, or even freight trucks. And if you can't tell what's inside that giant steel box, any container can be a deadly surprise package that can trigger the next Pearl Harbor event. There's a reason why all the usual suspects, the United States, Russia, China, Iran, and Israel, already have missile launchers hidden inside these innocuous-looking boxes. But why you don't actually need to sink ships to cause the next Pearl Harbor. How JLTVs can protect naval bases against drone attacks. And why launching a missile from a container ship can be a logistical nightmare is not what you think. Hiding missiles in containers isn't a new idea. The US Navy was already exploring this way back in the 1980s with the Arapaho program. Fast forward to the early 2000s and the US military launched the Affordable Weapons Program, proving they could successfully fit an entire cruise missile inside one of these unassuming boxes. Not to mention that the entire concept of masking weapons is not new either. During World War II, heavily armored merchant ships known as Q-ships disguised as ordinary vessels to lure German submarines into making surface attacks so they could be destroyed. Today, the US Army uses the Typhon missile system, which fits four vertical launch cells inside a 40-foot shipping container that's transported by truck. Typhon can launch both Tomahawk cruise missiles as well as SM-6 anti-air missiles. The Navy has a similar system, the Mark 70 payload delivery system. It's also a four-cell launcher inside a 40-foot container, designed to be dropped onto the flight decks of littoral combat ships or moved by trucks on land. Israel has LORA, a ballistic missile with a 250-mile range, which can be launched directly from a container stationed on the deck of a ship. Over a decade ago, Russia managed to fit four Kalibr cruise missiles into a shipping container. This became known as the infamous Club K system, which first became public in 2010. And where Russia goes, China often follows. The Chinese developed their own version of the Club K, showing it off at the 2022 Zhuhai Air Show. This move was deeply tied to China's long-term plan to militarize its vast commercial shipping sector. In fact, since 2017, China has had a law requiring its transport companies, even those overseas, to support the military whenever they're asked. To understand the true threat, let's break down the advantages of weaponizing containers. Given its stealth, a major advantage of containerized weapon systems is the ability to move via existing civilian infrastructure, such as trucks, rail, or cargo ships. This allows such weapon systems to be positioned near critical targets without the adversary having the slightest clue, substantially increasing the possibility of a preemptive strike. Just like Israel did in June 2025, when it used assets, including shipping containers, to launch a drone attack that destroyed the Iranian air defenses. The element of surprise given by such weapon systems can be a decisive factor in conflicts. Now multiply that by hundreds, like you see on a commercial vessel, and you have the potential for an entire floating arsenal hidden in plain sight. Another advantage of containerized weapon systems is deployment flexibility. That is, you can fit a variety of weapon systems inside shipping containers. It's not just missiles, but also drone swarms, electromagnetic jamming equipment, and other advanced capabilities. For example, Rheinmetall's Hero 126 loitering munitions can be launched from within a standard shipping container. Even a small 10-foot unit can pack enough of a punch, as seen by Electro-Optic Systems' container-based weapon system. With a lifting mechanism that can take up to a payload of 5,000 pounds, it can carry several different weapons and ammo components, ranging from the M134 minigun, 40mm automatic grenade launchers, and even the 30mm M230 Bushmaster. Coupled with a remote control system, a simple box can become a modular, remote-controlled arsenal tailored for the needs of any battlefield. Finally, containers are the ultimate decoys. Because any steel box could be a weapon, scattering a massive number of them across a battlefield creates utter chaos for the enemy. It simply becomes too expensive and time-consuming for them to find and destroy every single possible target. But the future is going completely all-in-one. Imagine systems that can launch missiles and drones, pack electronic warfare capabilities, and maybe even run an AI-driven sentry gun. And speaking of AI, these containers are designed to go fully autonomous. They're expected to run themselves, making decisions and operating with almost zero human input once deployed. Another example happened in June 2025, when Ukrainians pulled off Operation Spiderweb. They smuggled 117 drones into Russia, hiding them right inside the double roofs of modular homes carried on 5 freight trucks. While the wooden sheds were not shipping containers, the concept was identical: perfect concealment. These 5 innocent-looking trucks were actually heading to 5 different air bases, the homes of Russia's strategic bombers. On the operation day, as the drivers pulled up next to the installations, those roofs remotely popped open, and drones started taking off one by one. The drones had to rely on artificial intelligence to guide themselves toward the Russian aircraft, because the time delay and communication loss over long distances would have made remote piloting unfeasible. According to Ukrainians, drones successfully hit 41 military aircraft that included nearly a dozen Tu-95 strategic bombers. The operation was deemed a massive success by Ukrainians. Military analysts quickly labeled this Russia's Pearl Harbor. But the real question is, could an attack like this happen in the United States? Since the Al-Qaeda suicide bombing attack on USS Cole in 2000, the US naval base's security measures have been focused on surface attacks. Currently, all naval bases not only have 24/7 harbor patrol boats, but also port security barriers, which can protect against boats and naval drones. However, these measures will not help against attacks from aerial drones. In fact, to see how vulnerable American naval installations could be, look no further than the January 2024 incident when the FBI arrested a Chinese national, Fengyun Shi, after he flew a drone right over the Newport News shipyard and other classified naval installations while snapping pictures. You might think, great job, FBI, you caught a spy. But how they caught him is the truly worrisome part. The only reason Shi was arrested was because he flew his drone directly into a tree near the facility. It was only after the authorities retrieved the damaged drone and checked the memory card that they found photos of shipyards building nuclear submarines and aircraft carriers. But how could a small drone possibly take out a warship like an Arleigh destroyer? While underway, a US Navy destroyer is combat ready and can easily shred a swarm of drones. But when it's docked, all those combat systems are basically inactive, leaving the whole fleet exposed. Which makes you wonder, how hard would it be to completely disable the US Navy's Atlantic fleet? Picture this: a commercial container ship heads to Norfolk International Terminal, located just south of Norfolk Naval Base, where the Atlantic Fleet is stationed. Suddenly, a few hundred drones launch from those deck-side containers from less than 5,000 feet away and swarm the moored warships. These drones, of course, cannot sink the warships, but they don't need to. They just have to hit the four Spy 1 radars on those Arleigh Burke destroyers and Ticonderoga cruisers. By knocking out the radars, the ship's anti-air capabilities are instantly disabled, meaning they can no longer launch their interceptors. The result is that the entire US battle group, including the massive carrier strike groups, is crippled and cannot deploy for a very long time. That's because the current production rate for new Spy 6 radars is only 8 to 10 units per year, and each destroyer needs 4 to regain 360-degree defense coverage. We're talking years to fix that fleet, and this is not just some idea that I made up. There are articles published by Navy personnel that warn about these exact vulnerabilities. Now, just like Ukrainians targeted four Russian bases simultaneously, imagine an adversary targeting multiple naval bases where Arleigh Burke destroyers and Ticonderoga cruisers are stationed. For example, Naval Station Mayport, Norfolk, and San Diego. It could literally be a second, third, and fourth Pearl Harbor. An actual swarm of drones launched from containers against the US Navy fleet would have catastrophic strategic consequences. First, it would instantly slash the US Navy's deployable fighting force. Second, American naval bases would no longer be secure hubs of operations, forcing the entire remaining fleet to stay constantly on the move. But here's the massive turning point. Once an attack like this happens, it gives the United States the authority to immediately target any civilian cargo ship that looks suspicious without worrying about international pushback. Every single cargo ship will become a valid military target, drastically increasing the chance of hitting innocent civilian vessels by accident, causing a global security overdrive, intense paranoia for militaries, governments, and shipping companies worldwide. One thing, however, is certain. This is the new age of asymmetric warfare. Containerized weapon systems effectively level the playing field, making it possible for smaller nations and even non-state actors to suddenly challenge the most technologically advanced militaries in the world. Thankfully, launching weapons from a container ship is more complicated than you think. It's estimated that 25 million cargo containers enter the United States annually, but only 3% of them arriving by ship are physically inspected. Inspecting every single container would not only paralyze trade, but also undermine global confidence in the shipping system that underpins 90% of the world's commerce. This is exactly what happened in the aftermath of Operation Spiderweb, with Russia beefing up truck inspections in the regions infiltrated during the Ukrainian operation. Since it's completely unrealistic to scan or physically check every single container, the only real option is developing next-level drone swarm counter-defenses.
So what would you do to protect our naval installations and assets from unmanned threats? And how would you work across the federal agencies to make sure that we don't have a modern-day Pearl Harbor with drone swarm or any other types of modern attacks?
But it's something we've been watching for several years, understanding we're not well-equipped at all of our bases to handle that threat.
Since modern drones rely on sophisticated AI algorithms to guide themselves to targets, simply spoofing GPS may no longer be sufficient. So what do you do? Enter the Marine Air Defense Integrated System, or MADIS. MADIS is deployed across two JLTVs. One JLTV handles the radar and command systems, while the other is pure firepower. It's loaded with a 30mm cannon, Stinger missiles, and electromagnetic countermeasures. Deploying these MADIS-equipped JLTVs in sufficient numbers across military installations might be the best defense there is right now. But how would Navy bases defend against missile attacks? In case of a traditional long-range missile attack, Naval Station Norfolk is already protected by layered air defense systems that are not publicly disclosed. But what if missiles were launched from container ships passing nearby? See, sneaking a missile launcher into a container is orders of magnitude harder than smuggling drones. That's simply because a missile launcher would be much heavier than almost any commercial cargo that's transported inside containers. And remember, heavy containers typically go at the bottom to keep the ship's center of gravity low and prevent capsizing. But to fire a missile, the container has to be stacked on the very top so that the roof can pop open to launch it. In contrast, drones could possibly launch from the side of a container. Long story short, putting missile containers on top of the stack would require months of planning and the collaboration of the ship's crew, the team loading the containers with cranes, and many more. Which means such an operation would only be possible by a powerful state actor, not just a few people with a missile launcher and bad intentions.